Mike was always an eloquent and mind-changing champion of two-year colleges and of their underappreciated faculty and students. He always recognized the challenging and culturally important work of two-year college instructors, and he always fought to elevate the work we do in our classrooms with the population of students that we teach and that he wrote about. His elegant prose and memorable stories won us new allies and gave us a renewed sense of confidence.
I'm going to begin with a few thoughts on a wonderful article by Christy Toth and Pat Sullivan and Carolyn Calhoun Dillahunt in the September 2019 issue of College Composition and Communication. It's titled "The Two-Year College Teacher Scholar Activism: Reconstructing the Disciplinary Matrix of Writing Studies." I suspect many of you have read it. It's an ambitious article. The author is drawing on a range of two-year college scholars' work along with their own to argue for an enhanced definition of writing studies that foregrounds its public and civic purpose and its student advocacy and its need for common cause across disciplines and types of institutions. Now, one of the things that I most appreciate about this article is its focus on the two-year college as a site of knowledge making, that those working in the two-year college, as well as those matriculating in it, give rise to a rich body of knowledge about important and timely topics that, to my mind, range from adult development and learning to the sociology and economics of education to the contemporary value and application of the disciplines from the humanities to the applied sciences. And such knowledge, of course, is generated elsewhere, but in the two-year college, it's an especially rich source with a robust public purpose.
Pay attention to your writing. Writing will be part of your intellectual and professional toolkit for the rest of your careers. Make your criticisms as even-handed as you can, because you're going to be called upon to critique a reading or to critique a policy or an educational practice. Now, don't just be a flamethrower about it. Right? Before launching into your critique, do your best to present the reading or policy or practice as fairly as you can, even if it really irritates you to do so. Then you develop your critique. Your critique will be all the more effective if your reader sees you being even-handed. Now, here's an important point. That doesn't mean you're being wishy-washy or that you can't take a strong point of view. You can. In fact, I think the strongest critiques are the ones that fairly present elements of the argument or policy or practice that you're questioning, and then systematically, point by point, deconstruct them or demonstrate their inadequacy.
And when you get in close, this is, I think, the point of the mind at work, when you get in close to blue-collar and service work done well, there's just a remarkable amount of intelligence, of mental acuity on display. And I just wish we were better as a culture at acknowledging that. Because if we were, I think it would have an effect on some of the kind of schooling we create. I think it would have an effect on the way we organize work, the kinds of responsibilities we give people. And I sure think it would have an effect on some of the cultural divides that are creating such heat right now in the culture. I firmly believe that some of the kind of political and cultural tensions that emerge are because, working class folk feel the disdain, I think, that some of the culture have. My entrance tests, you always take IQ tests and all that sort of thing when you enter school. And my tests were confused with somebody else's, and I was placed in the vocational track, which everybody pretty much admits is, with few exceptions, a euphemism for the bottom rung. And I stayed there for a couple years and drifted more and more to the level of a really mediocre and quite unprepared student. What's interesting to me about that is not that this unusual thing happened to me, but it shows how arbitrary some of that kind of placement could be. It also shows how students placed, and I try to show this in the book, how students placed in that sort of track live down to the expectations. Yeah. I learned that virtually any kid who has been written off, virtually any kid who has that thick cum folder full of failure, has an ability and a potential that we simply don't see.